Hi folks, this is Dan Bell with Intergent. Today I want to spend a few minutes discussing licensing for specifically the team member role, the folks who will update the tasks of the projects in Project for the Web, and what that looks like and how it functions. So the first thing I want to do is confirm the license that I have assigned to my test user. That would be Daniel Shackelford here. If we look at the license, we can see that we have an Office E3. Therefore, the two licenses that are okay or can function with this are the Office E3 and the Office E5, okay? All right, with that said, we have the license assigned. What I'm gonna do as the project manager, I am the project manager. I'm gonna go ahead and work with this team member demo project here. And in this project, I'm gonna create a couple of tasks. We'll just create a design task and a build task. And I'm gonna have a 2-day duration on both. Keep it real simple. Just like that. And then I'm gonna add a couple of group members here. First of all, I'm gonna make this public, and then it's gonna add me by default. Therefore, I just need to specify the other individual, Shackelford, who has that team member license, right, the E3. Two group members, you can see myself and Dan Shackelford. Great, we're looking good. All right, so let's go ahead and assign resources. We'll assign Shackelford to just the design task. We'll assign Shackelford and me to the build task. That's exactly the way I want this to be. Okay, look at the timeline. I should see the Gantt chart here as well. I do, two tasks. Not concerned about this project reflecting reality at all in this case. All done with the project here. So what we're gonna do is switch gears and go look at the project from that team member, Dan Shackelford's role. And what I did is I created another profile in my Google Chrome, and I'm gonna open a completely different browser and log in at that user. All right, now we're logged in as Daniel Shackelford. There's that team member demo project. We'll go ahead and click on that to open it up. And again, you know, similar to what we saw before, the two tasks, Dan Shackelford, myself and Shackelford. But another thing you're gonna notice is it says limited access here. It's basically alerting us to the fact that you can only mark your assigned tasks complete or change their percent complete. In order to edit the project or create a new one, you need a subscription to project, meaning you need a project plan 1, 3, or 5 license. Okay, great. All right, let's go ahead and we'll add the percent complete column here. And I'm gonna update both of these to 50%, right? Nice, very easy, okay? And we'll leave it at that for now. Let's go back as the project manager and take a peek at these. We'll go to home and then we'll reopen it. And great, we can see that they're both progressed. Nice, looking good so far. What I'm gonna do is add one more task, and I'm not gonna assign Dan to it, just to demonstrate that he can only assign, or rather only update the task that he's assigned to, okay? And we'll assign myself to that one, and then we'll create deploy, and we will not assign anyone to that. Okay, so again, just a test to see what those look like. The other question that, you know, some of you project managers are probably thinking is this: there's two resources assigned to this one. Shackelford specified 50%. Is that 50% for the task or for just Dan Shackelford's work? Interesting, that's one of the first questions I had when I saw this. And that's why I did a little more testing, and the next test we do, we're gonna confirm that. Let's go back into Dan Shackelford's environment here, into his profile, click on team member demo. Okay, there we go. We have the additional tasks, design, build, and then test and deploy were added. Okay, Dan Bell, myself, is assigned to test, nobody to deploy. If you look at the percent complete, notice that I cannot, right, make any changes. There's that pencil with the cross through it there. That just means I cannot edit that. I can only edit tasks that are assigned to me. If I click on the information button there to bring up the task detail, notice all of these are grayed out. I cannot do anything. So this is key. This is exactly what you're going to want for your projects when your team members update them. You're going to want the team member to only be able to update the task they're assigned to. All right, so let's do this. We're going to update these both to 100% now, right? And we'll do the same to this one, 100%. And we're done, and it, notice it strikes a line through both of them. So this really is indicating to me that both these tasks overall, not just Mr. Shackelford's work, but both overall have been finished completely. All right, what I wanna do is go back to the project manager's instance and confirm the same, and yes, indeed, there's the build task. Dan Shackelford and myself were assigned to that. Shackelford specified it was 100% complete. Sure enough, it did make it 100% complete for the entire task. Therefore, when you as the project manager are building these projects, if it's important for you to know that Dan Shackelford completed his work before, different from or complete or differentiated from Dan Bell, you're going to want to consider the way you build your tasks, right? So you're going to want to have two different tasks, and then you'll assign one resource to each task so you can track each resource's specific progress on their tasks, okay? Just like I did here, right? The progress on this one task was only Dan Shackelford's work, whereas if I had me assigned here, like so, and I specified, you know, whatever it is, 25% complete, you know, that 25% complete is just for me on my task. Okay, so there you go, folks. Hopefully you learned something from that. I certainly did today. That was great, understanding the license requirements for your team members. Again, the E3 or E5 is going to give it to you. If you have any questions, comments, or requests for additional videos, don't hesitate to reach out. Be happy to help out. Thanks so much.